Let's all say goodbye to long hours of editing and hello to more consistent output. In this video, I'll be showing you how to edit your vertical videos with Adobe Stock to make them go from this to this. Creating professional looking vertical content for your ads might feel very time consuming, especially if you want to stay consistent, but Adobe Stock has a ton of templates that will allow you to improve your workflow, especially because they are just so simple, plug and play. All right, let's head over to the Adobe Stock website. We're going to click on the templates button on the tabs up top. We are then going to click on the magnifying glass button to bring up all of the filters on the left-hand side here. Adobe Stock has a ton of templates for all of their apps that they offer, but this video is specifically about vertical video, and I preferably use Premiere Pro to edit all of my videos. So I'm just gonna click on Premiere Pro to filter out all the other templates. Next, I'm gonna scroll down to the orientation. I'm gonna click vertical. One thing about templates is that this is just a starting ground. You can go ahead and adjust your fonts. You can adjust the colors and customize it so that it reflects your business brand identity. In the project window, you'll see render. This is the main sequence. So this is your home base to find all of the layers. I've gone ahead and imported some media and some text, and I'm going to show you how to easily drag and drop and customize it. With this template, I created a little teaser for a trailer video I got to make with Adobe Stock and a wonderful cast and crew. And so I was able to drag and drop videos into these animated boxes and write up a blurb about this piece. So this could be a really good template if you are a marketing company, let's say, and you launch a new product or you launch a new campaign. This is a really good opportunity to drop photos or videos into the placeholders and then maybe have a little blurb in one of these text boxes explaining maybe the client or the description of the product. Media one is that grayed out box here. I'm going to double click into media one. This gives you a nest. I'm going to click into that one more time. And the description says you are media here. Ideally, you want your media to extend to the same length as this. With the playhead at the front of the timeline, I'm going to command V and paste a section of this short trailer into this media section. And when I go back to render, it pops right up here on screen. So if I go to play it from the beginning, it should play out perfectly. You can easily drag and drop photos into this template, but I really like using video, especially because you have the animation with the boxes. It just adds a lot more dynamic movement to your ad. Just to show you how easy this actually is, I'm going to customize some of the text that you see in the template. So I'm gonna click on text one. This will bring me into the nest. I'm gonna click on text one again. And then here it says custom text here. I'm gonna go to the properties panel and click on text. You can easily type in any text you want here, as well as adjust the font, the color, the size, anything you want. It's just very customizable. And when you go back to your render timeline, you'll be able to see that text appear on the bottom left as well. Let's do the same thing to media two. I'm gonna hit pause, click into media two, and here you have the same placeholder saying your media here. I'm going to command V from the other timeline I have going from the short trailer and make sure that the footage or the photo that you're dropping in is the same duration as the placeholder. And then you're just going to go back to the render page and see if you like the size, if you like how the animation treats the media. Sometimes we're not shooting for vertical, and so this kind of template will help you elevate all of that 16:9 footage, allow you to crop in and add a bit more personality. If you go ahead and you create that first vertical video that you really like, go ahead and duplicate that sequence. That will then allow you to batch create content for the rest of the quarter, the rest of the year. Duplicating that sequence will allow you to customize the text and the photos depending on what you want to advertise. Thank you so much for watching. Check out Adobe Stock for your next project and subscribe to the Adobe Creative Cloud YouTube channel.